Hello, everyone. I'm Anthony Bowker, and I'm the software engineer lead at Unity on the Webgl platform team. I've been at Unity now for 6 months, and I'm going to share with you today a little bit about Unity and its support for the web. Unity is a leading platform for creating interactive, real-time entertainment content, including things like film, animation, automotive, manufacturing, architecture, engineering, and the reason we're all here today, games. With Unity, we have this goal where you can build once, you can create your game once, and you can deploy it anywhere across mobile, desktop, consoles, and the web. The web has been an important target for Unity for a long time. We first previewed our WebGL target back in 2015. And before then, we even had a plugin web player for various browsers, so you could bring your content to the web that way. So let's dive in and have a quick look at how you build for the web. What I'm going to show you here is a way of creating a very simple 2D game within the Unity editor, and I'm going to use the Dragon Crashers project, which was released recently, as a sample 2D game that you can use with Unity. So we saw here that we opened the Unity editor, and first of all, we created a 2D game, and we changed the target platform to be WebGL. Now I can go to the Unity Asset Store, and from there I can find the Dragon Crashers Asset Bundle, and we can import this into our project. I've sped up for this recording some of the import stages, which are quite long the first time you do them. Once we have Dragon Crashers imported, we can go ahead and set the initial scene to be that start screen. I hope everyone can see this video okay. With this, we can then, if we wanted to, play it within the editor, but let's go ahead and make a build for the web. We open up the build settings window again. We can target our compilation for speed, build to a destination web directory, and then we pop that open in our development browser on our desktop. Dragon Crashers is the official sample project that was released recently, and it showcases a lot of the tools that come with using the Unity platform. It's an example of a sort of side-scrolling RPG game, and it sort of shows off the things like the skeletal animation, inverse kinematics, level design, and some of the shapes and pixel art tools that are available in Unity. This project and these assets are available free on the web for anyone to try. And as you can see, you can build very easily within the download of the Unity editor. I'd like to take a quick overview on, first of all, once we create the game with Unity, it's really designed so that it can be hosted anywhere. We saw in the demonstration that I hosted it locally on my own desktop machine for testing. Anyone can provide their own web server, provided that they set up the WASM MIME type. And we also provide within our build system pre-compression to Brotli as well. So if you configure the web server to supply Brotli files, you'll get that advantage of serving those in a compressed way. There's also many sites out there where you can then upload your Unity game and host it, including play.unity.com, which has become a very interesting way where users can quickly share what they've created with their friends and get feedback on a website that's free for anyone to use. The Unity WebGL target, as we saw in the demo, has a basic template that your game exists within. But essentially, all you need to do is give it a canvas element within your web application and then connect the Unity player to that. So those canvas elements or elements can then be embedded within any web page of your choice. Take a quick look here at how the Unity game arrives on the web. Unity is essentially a native C++ game engine, which is how it's supported across all of those different platforms. And it enables the user to create their game logic in C# game scripts. And so how do we get those onto the web? Unity includes this ahead of time compile step to C++. And this is something that's used across various different platforms where we want the user's C# game logic to be pre-compiled into native C++ from the get-go. On desktop platforms, you can also use the .NET core and run your game that way if you want as well, which is great for development because you get that faster iteration time. So on this slide, we show that the C# game logic, we first of all use the C# compiler to compile that to managed assemblies. This is using the intermediate language. The next step is we actually go through those intermediate language assemblies, which include your game logic, also things like the core framework, and we do a very aggressive stripping of all of the managed assemblies that you're not using. This is very important, particularly for the web, to remove anything that your game doesn't use. And so those stripped assemblies is what we then use, feed into the ahead of time compiler, IL to CPP. And that creates the C# C++ code, which we then bring together with the game libraries. And we can then compile either to, in this slide, a native binary for things like desktop or some of the consoles or the mobile platforms. Or for the web, we then use the mscripten toolchain to build that to run on top of WebAssembly. And that gives us near native speeds within the web browser. And it also allows us to then you target the WebGL as the graphics backend on the web. The Unity development team, particularly my colleague Yuka, has been contributing to the mscripten project for many years. Most recently, we did a contribution which supports some explicit uniform location binding to mscripten's handling of the GLSL shader support, so that if you're using an mscripten application which treats the graphic device as an OpenGL graphics device, it provides you the ability to lock your layouts in those shaders that you're using. And so using these technologies, the IL to CPP, and then the mscripten toolchain, is how we bring the Unity content, which is the C++ content and the user's C# scripts, to the web. And that's pretty cool, because now anyone can access their game just from a hyperlink away. For the remainder of the presentation, I'd like to talk a little bit about where we're headed with the Unity support for the web. And we've actually, at the GDC this year, announced that there's a public roadmap now on the Unity website, which is what all of the different groups within Unity are bringing forwards in future versions. With the web support, we're focused at this time on adding the support that we need in terms of features and in terms of the bundle code size to get us to a place where we can support Unity content on the mobile web. We all know that many users of the web come to their sites for mobile devices. And whilst in the past we've had solid desktop support, we want to bring that also to mobile as well. And so some of the things that are being worked on are support for compressed audio, which is necessary for things like background music. You heard the background music in the Dragon Crashers game there, so that that can remain compressed in memory rather than decompressing it within the browser. And likewise, support for mobile compressed texture formats within the web solution. And so that will allow you to support compressed textures straight through to the graphics hardware on the mobile devices. We're also including various mobile features like support for the gyroscope, gravity sensor, locking screen orientation, and the webcam, which are provided within Unity C# API. And so now you can bring those features through to the mobile web target as well. In addition to that, we're also going to be working on supporting faster build times within the Unity framework so that you can get more quickly through that process of those tool chains until you can use it on the web. Currently, we're targeting WebGL, and we'll also be working in the future towards things like Web GPU support. When that becomes available, Unity content will be there as well. The final thing I want to mention is an alternative way of using Unity to target the web, and that is with Project Tiny. What we've discussed so far is using the Unity editor that's been released for many years to create content for many devices. And that brings a whole wealth of tools, but it also creates fairly large, a large engine deployment and a large content that needs to be downloaded to your device. Project Tiny is really focused on providing a very modular runtime framework so that you can create your games in an instant way, so that they are small, light, and fast. Project Tiny is also built on top of the Unity's DOTS, which is a data-oriented technology framework, which is available. The previous Unity that we looked at was using game objects and more of an object-oriented flavor of development. Project Tiny is currently in development, so it's only available for preview at the moment. So if you want to look at it, go ahead, but it's not yet ready for prime time and production ready. And I have here a quick demo of a game created last fall, Skelly Buddies. And this targets here the web. And as you can see, it has that mobile form factor right out of the box. In the slides, I've got another quick demo as well, but I see that my 10 minutes are up. So we'll move over to Q&A. Thank you.